Let's practice this a little bit. Please write down the call stack for the following code. We have a main function, which calls the function called sqr. But write down how the stack frame could look like at location 1, so when the instruction pointer would just have passed this lane here. And then after you called sqr at this line, how would the two activation records look like? Please pause the video now, spend the time and draw this little picture on the stack, and then continue after you are done and I will show you the answer. So here is now the solution, or one potential solution that is a bit simplified. So when we talk about location 1, that means we started in our main function, we processed this line, we are here at location 1. So what do we have to store on our stack, in particular on our stack activation frame? For main, we will see that we have only the variable y, which is set to 5, and we have unknown value for this return variable that is returned by the main. So now let's, from this function, we call sqr, and in sqr we find location 2. What are the local variables? Well, first of all, we have now two frames on our stack. One is the main activation record, which we had before, so we can basically take the same. But now on top, we have also the function sqr and its activation record. So here we have to remember that an argument is also a local variable, so we have to keep it. And at this point, on location 2, the return value is unknown, so we can put the two question marks or one question mark.